So one of the very first You're Wrong About videos I ever did was You're Wrong About the SCP Wiki, in which I explained how there is no canon on the wiki. And in that video, I do briefly mention that there are set canons, but I don't really talk about them too much. Today, we're going to talk about those canons and how you can write for them and what they really mean. So there are at least 32 canons on the wiki as of this video's recording. Out of those, I have, looking at the list anyway, about 8 of these canons I've written in, and about 4, I think, I've actually started myself. So that's actually a pretty good percentage of the total. Now, to be fair, none of the canons I started were started alone. It's always good to have other people to help you out with the beginning, mainly because in order to create a canon, you have to have at least 3 authors anyway, so it's nice to work together with other people. That's sort of the whole point of it. Which dovetails nicely into the basics of what is a canon on the SCP Wiki, and I can read from the canon page right now to explain what a, say, series of articles needs to have in order to qualify as a canon. The instructions are very simple. If you're wanting to build a canon and have it added to the page, the important thing to remember is that it must be a shared project. To qualify for inclusion, your canon must meet the following requirements. 1. A minimum of 5 articles written. 2. A minimum of 3 authors writing those articles. 3. Your canon cannot be closed to other new contributors. And 4. Your canon can never be finished. And remember, collaboration and innovation is the point of this. That is the purpose of creating a canon. Now, there are writers on the SCP Wiki who, some of these comments either went over their head or maybe they were written specifically to call them out in a little way. I'm not going to name who those people are, but I think a lot of the people listening who do know will know exactly who I'm talking about. The thing is, creating a canon essentially takes control of your created world out of your hands, because you're basically saying that it's now a collaborative project that anyone is invited to participate in. And anything you do, or anything anyone else does, can be valid in your world as long as it doesn't directly contradict something that's already been written. Now, there are authors who disagree with that perspective. But when I was creating the Aces and Eights canon, which is, I think, the most recent one I've created, I was looking at it, and this is the one I probably had the, I'd say, the strongest editorial hand in, which is ironic because I was trying to create it as free and open of a canon as possible. It's an Old West canon, where essentially the SCP Foundation was never formed, but a lot of the modern elements of the SCP Foundation exist in the Old West, but in a different form. So it's essentially just take the modern foundation and set it in the Old West. What does SCP-682 look like in that world? And in mine, it's like unstoppable Confederate cavalry brigade called the 682nd that during the night will go out and just destroy towns. Or Dr. Kondracki is actually Conrad Drake, Sheriff Riddle. But that actually sort of belies the point of creating a canon. What you're doing is you're creating a shared world that other people can participate in, but there usually needs to be some sort of, let's say, event or some sort of premise that differentiates it from the baseline canon. So like I said, in Aces and Eights, it's set in the Old West. That's literally the only real difference. But in Straight On Till Morning, there's an elaborate backstory where the Earth has been switched with another planet, and the SCP Foundation forces in space in 1973 are unable to figure out how to get back home. So they create a fleet and they, a la Battlestar Galactica, try to find Earth. So in those two different canons, one set in a Old West style and one is set in a science fiction style, you can actually see the two different, the two different kinds of canons there can be. One is setting, Old West, and one is an event that happens that affects all future stories. And you can see this in other SCP canons as well, like Unfounded is literally just the SCP Foundation was never founded and everything else is exactly the same. What does the world look like? That makes Unfounded kind of a mixture of setting and event, but in this particular case, it's more of a negative space thing since it's about something that didn't happen, but which is taken for granted in the modern SCP Wiki. Ultimately, though, how these canons come to form very much differs from person to person or canon to canon. And even as someone who has created four, and I've had a hand in the creation of a couple others, but like I wouldn't necessarily consider myself one of the founders of those canon, or even like a primary contributor. I just was there at the beginning for some of them. And some canons are giant. Like, Resurrection has probably a dozen authors, maybe more. It would be difficult to keep count. And a lot of them are the old school authors that you know, like Dr. Clef or Dr. Bright or the Deadly Moose, or just people who were writing for the SCP Wiki a long time ago and are well known for being high quality writers. But I'm going to talk a little bit about how a variety of the ones I've helped to found were created to give you an idea of how you might want to go about creating your own canon. So first we're going to talk a little bit about Aces and Eights. It's the last canon I've worked on so far, and it's the one I had the most probably creative control over. It's about 15 articles in it so far. And what happened with it is, I wrote a tale called Now Hollow Fires Burn Out to Black and Lights Are Guttering Low, which was sort of supposed to be an introduction to the canon, but it didn't really catch on. I wrote it for a contest back in 2017 for the history contest, which I believe it won in the tale category. And for the longest time, it was rated, plus 70, plus 80, something along those lines. It got most of its votes during the contest and didn't really start to accumulate any more. And then late last year, some people were talking, I think it was in Discord, about how, man, they really wish they could write the SCP stuff in the Old West, and it led to some conversations where I pointed out I'd actually written a tale set that way, and I had created a setting where essentially, SCP-682, Kondraki, the Old Man, and a couple of other SCPs, Cain and Abel as well, were involved in the story, but in versions that were set for the Wild West. And a bunch of people got together and started really wanting to work on this as a concept and independently came up with their own tales. And a lot of times people will come to me, because some canons are run with a bit more of a heavy hand by the person who's creating them, and be like, can I do this? And my answer is always, yes, absolutely. You don't even need to ask me. Just write it. And write something you enjoy, set in the setting. You know, and as long as it doesn't contradict what's already been written, I don't care. And so far, it's worked out pretty well. I mean, a 15-tale canon is actually pretty good, and as I said, each of these stories generally stands on its own anyway, so it's not like it's a continuing story that hasn't been finished. It's just going to keep going, forever. And that is in opposition to the very first canon I helped found, which has a completely different genesis. The first one I helped found was The Gulf, and I co-founded it with myself and Kate McTerris. Incipient Paroxysm, I believe, another author who isn't really on the site anymore, neither is Kate, but Kate McTerris and Incipient both contributed, but Kate was really the driving creative force behind it, and I was like kind of a secondary guy who bounced ideas off of, came up, you know, whatever. I wasn't the primary contributor in the creation of it, but I was enough of a secondary to consider myself a co-creator. And what essentially had happened with The Gulf, anyway, is that myself, Incipient Paroxysm, and Kate McTerris were all writing in the same setting. And what had happened was Kate had been on the site already, and she was writing some really great works with its own kind of twist on it. And myself and Incipient were fans of that particular setting, and it was also set in the southeast of the U.S. where I live, and I believe Incipient also lived. And so we basically just picked out places where we were and decided that those areas were what we would focus on. And a lot of authors do this. You'll see a lot of DJ Cactus's stuff is set in Indiana. So you learn, you know, you write from where you're from, and The Gulf is that for me. See, that's why I say Site 88 is set up in Alabama. It's much further south than where I live, but it is set in my state because I wanted to set something in, like, the area I live that I had a better connection to. But yeah, what happened was all three of us were writing in this shared setting without realizing what the requirements for a canon even were. And we all had completely different reasons for doing it and completely different stories, but the same basic setting, which used Kate's world as a backdrop. And then one day I was looking at the canon page and saw that we had already met the requirements for building a canon. We just needed to name it and create a hub, which is what happened. Kate, being the fantastic writer that she is, had an idea for like a shared story that we were all going to work on, and it was really very structured, and it is probably what killed the Canon before it even started. See, she posted the hub, we started getting working on it, and it just died. And the only author who stuck around, and what happens is that authors don't stick around on the SCP Wiki. So if you have somebody else you're working with, and it's like important that they actually stick around and work with you on the thing, it doesn't work when they leave, and people will leave. Like, I've been around for about 5 years now writing. I've been on the wiki since 2012, but I started writing in 2014. And while I'll probably never go anywhere, I have to expect that most of the people I work with will eventually move on or do something else. So creating canon with someone else can be very difficult if you rely on that person to be the primary driving force, and that's what Kate was. So when she left, the canon, even though I still write tales based in it, kind of died. The Gulf is a particularly influential canon, and it really heavily had an influence on Resurrection. Now, Resurrection exists without the Gulf, but a lot of what happened in the Gulf is canon to Resurrection, and that's another thing about SCP articles or tales. They can be canon to more than one canon. As long as what's in them doesn't directly contradict to a particular canon's premise or setting, an article can exist in multiple canons. And one of those that I'd like to point out is SCP-2987, which I believe exists in at least three, if not four, canons. It exists in AIAD, it shows up in at least one of those stories, it shows up in Resurrection, it shows up in the Gulf, obviously, and the thing about the Gulf and Resurrection is that anything that could be in the Gulf could be in Resurrection because they're so interconnected, but the Resurrection canon is much bigger and actually, you know, really establishes its world, and also, it's part of those twists. Twisted Pines, which I actually didn't know originally. I learned somewhat after the fact that SCP-2987 kind of had an influence on the creation of those Twisted Pines. Not a huge, like not an outsized influence, but it had a strong influence on its early creation because it was about, you know, Anderson Robotics and working with Marshall Carter and Dark and what that would look like. My absolute favorite founding of an SCP wiki canon, though, has got to be the Ship in a Bottle canon, which is just, it's the funniest thing I've ever seen. So the Friendly Vandal wrote a tale called Second Date, and in it, Clef and Kondraki have a relationship, and it's implied to be a romantic relationship. And also, there is an event that goes on in the past of the story, where Dr. Kondraki accidentally gets his, we'll say, private parts, so that YouTube doesn't demonetize my video, stuck in a Aquafina water bottle, specifically an Aquafina brand water bottle. And what happened was, some homophobic people didn't like the idea of putting Clef and Kondraki together on the website, so they complained a lot and loudly, and one of them actually contacted Dr. Clef, and as I mentioned, Dr. Clef and Dr. Kondraki were the ones that were involved in the romantic relationship. One of them contacted the writer, Dr. Clef, and complained at them about what was going on in the article. And Dr. Clef's response was my favorite response ever. He wrote a sequel independently of The Friendly Vandal. And then things went uphill from there because there are now a total of 10 articles in that canon. In fact, I'm the one that wrote the sixth one. I wish I could have been in the first five. That would have been great. But as soon as I read it, I was like, oh, no, I have to do this. And I will mention, some of these tales are very not safe for work. So, you know, keep that in mind if you go to look this up. But it just goes to show that the creation of a canon can come in many different forms. Some of them are planned and some of them are very unplanned. I think the most important thing to keep in mind if you're planning on founding a canon on the SCP Wiki is that you are giving up complete control over the canon when you create it. As long as you're creating a tale series, you don't ever have to say that it exists in the same canon as somebody else's story, because there is no canon. But the minute you decide to try and get the extra promotion and recognition and prestige of having a canon on the SCP Wiki, you are giving up control in order to get those things. And there are authors, I mentioned at the very beginning, who don't like that idea. They feel like they should be able to get all the benefits without giving anything away, but that's the trade-off you gotta make. And if you can't accept that, you need to not make it a canon. Anyway, that's it. And now, I'd like to give special thanks to my patrons. I have three new patrons to list off today. We have Jalen Tucknies, we have Mikolaj Zarziki, and Rail Braun. Rail Braun pledged at $5, and Mikolaj and Jalen pledged at $20 each. Thank you very much. I genuinely appreciate it. This is the kind of thing that means I can continue to make this content for my subscribers and everyone who wants to learn more about the SCP Wiki, or even if they don't want to learn how to write for it. Maybe they just enjoy this content. It's nice that I can continue to create it for them. If you like this content, you can pledge on Patreon yourself at patreon.com/dcimmerian and get your name into a video as well. If that's not for you, scroll down just a little bit and hit the subscribe button, then hit the notification bell next to that. It's how I know I'm not alone out here. And I'll see you again on Thursday.